Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, this is going to be a old school broadcast for you today on this Tuesday, 25th day of February 2014. Power is off to large sections of South Austin where our studio is based. We have backup generators, but I guess not enough of them to be able to run all the cameras, the lights, and the video streams. But we do have audio streams going up to the satellites and the audio streams at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. And this only happens about once a year, and usually when the power goes out, we have enough backup power on batteries to keep running, but it's been out since about 7 a.m. this morning, and so we exhausted the backup batteries and are on generator right now, and I guess we need more generators is the answer, because I need enough to run the TV network, all of it. Our websites are obviously hosted outside this facility, but that is what is going on right now, and it's almost like a shindig here at the office, and most of the equipment's not working, and there's still not power at a lot of different areas, and so folks are kind of standing around the coffee cooler. Hell, I might just take off and go play pool or something. Who knows? No, but seriously, folks, we are broadcasting worldwide on this Tuesday edition, and we had a lady that I was really excited about getting on because I remember interviewing her back in the late 90s, Kathleen Wiley. WorldNet Daily's put out her new book, Target, Caught in the Crosshairs of Bill and Hillary Clinton. She was one of the women sexually assaulted by Herr Clinton, the male Clinton, the goblin-like Clinton. And she was scheduled today, but we're going to do that tomorrow or the next day when we're fully operational here at the old facility. That said, I mentioned this some yesterday, but didn't make a big enough deal out of it because it really is an ultra-massive issue. And if you go up to places like DrudgeReport.com, the era of designer babies is here. Dad may join two moms for disease-free babies, designer babies. Of course, the argument is it's all genetic, but a lot of it is you're predisposed genetically. But then why are all these disorders and cancers up? It's the chemicals, the biologicals, the radiologicals on record in all the studies that are triggering these gene disorders to manifest. And so as we get more and more toxic in the environment from GMO and other things that on record sterilize 99% of guinea pigs after three generations, does the same thing to humans and other mammals. Well, not just mammals, but creatures with spinal columns, period, vertebrates. But we're here looking at all this. This is the end of humanity. And then they toxify us, and then we're unable to reproduce without artificial systems in the government-run healthcare system. And then they add the social engineering and the backdoor engineering, just like they've done into smartphones, computers, smart meters, you name it, into our very genetics. And that is the next level. So, you know, it's funny. I got up this morning and was mad at myself for not really getting into this in depth yesterday. I mentioned it some, and then I went up to Drudge and saw that that was the top story, and so we're on the same page there. This really is a big deal with the cloning and the GMO and all of it. I want to talk about the future we face and what it's going to look like and what it's going to be like coming up today, and we've canceled the guests we had, so I'll also kind of do it C-SPAN style, where you can talk about Obamacare, how you liking that. You can talk about Ukraine. We can talk about any of the big issues that are out there and have a discussion about where you see the future going. So I'll open the phones up as well in the first hour, actually. And then as I start the second hour, I'll do a breakdown on the situation with the designer babies. FDA weighs risk of three-person embryo fertilization. That's all coming up today. And I'll give the number out when we come back on the other side of this quick break. But again, I'm coming to you from near darkness with one little light bulb in here in the broadcast studio. Great job of the crew keeping us up and running. So our backup systems at least got us on the minimum, which is radio, which is about 90% of our audience. We'll be right back. Sorry to PrisonPlanet.tv members on video.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Well, this is a old school style radio broadcast today. We're not simulcasting video for folks watching on PrisonPlanet.tv because there's been a sustained power outage today in South Austin where our studios are located. So we're on generator backup power right now, broadcasting across the planet. But the main heart of the transmission is and has always been radio. So we are here, ladies and gentlemen, broadcasting worldwide on this Tuesday, the 25th day already of February 2014. I am rescheduling Kathleen Wiley, who was sexually assaulted by Bill Clinton, and he settled with her. Target caught in the crosshairs of Bill and Hillary Clinton. I am rescheduling her because I want to be able to have the full production when she does join us. So we're going to have open phones today. This is going to be C-SPAN style radio, where I'm going to take a lot of your phone calls. Oh, and by the way, John Harmon, I don't even have computers in here. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to be texting to my globalist tracking Trojan horse surveillance system iPhone. You're going to be texting me the callers to that. So that'll be a good way for me to be able to take the calls. You know, I've done a lot of remotes over the years, from the Grand Canyon to rodeos and car shows and golf ranges, so, and shooting ranges. So this is really no big deal. I am here basically doing a remote from Austin, Texas, with one light bulb on above my head. And I do have some wireless iPads and things, so I'm able to scan the news as it unfolds and as it develops. So that is what we are doing here today. Just letting you know why there are no video feeds at PrisonPlanet.tv or Infowars.com/show, where we have the free feeds. Now, there is so much, obviously, to cover today. But in the interest of shaking up the transmission, I am going to just mention some of the headlines, and then I'm going to give the phone number out to everyone. It's 800-259-9231. You can talk about any subject. You can be a long-time caller, first-time caller. All I ask is that you be awake, because we don't screen your calls, so we get some bad calls. We get some really good ones, too. And all I ask is that you not be drunk. And all I ask is that you have your point that you make and that we move to the next person. You can call in and agree with me. You can call in and disagree. If you've got a beef, you can call in and tell me how much you want to beat me up. That's usually what some people want to call in about. I want to hear what you think about the Ukraine situation now, with Russia sending troops in to an area of the Ukraine, Crimea, and Russian generals saying that they're facing an information war in an attempt to break up countries on their border. That's definitely what's happening. We've got other articles here where Soros Group triples its lobbying spending here in the United States and worldwide. His open society foundations that are overthrowing countries and funding the Arab Spring and funding just every nasty organization under the sun. It's not like the Russians are great either, but I mean, George Soros, the guy that wants our guns, is the one funding a lot of the Ukrainian opposition. That's in the Washington Post today, and it dovetails with this article out of the Washington Times with the headline, Obama proposes IRS rules to limit tax-exempt status. So they're going to restrict basically anybody who isn't a communist. But George Soros can run around with his billions of dollars and do anti-gun initiatives, anti-free speech initiatives, and be a well-known Nazi collaborator. That's cool. He gets ADL awards because of that. Then we criticize Nazis, and so we get ADL attack pieces. That's just how it works when the globalists are running things. Also, I mentioned this yesterday, but I really want to spend a lot of time on it in the second hour. I want to talk about the globalist master plan to radically transform humans to where we can't even reproduce, and to basically build Trojan horses into our genetics to totally control us in a brave new world, just as they've done with the smartphones, the smart meters, the smart refrigerators, the smart appliances, as total control grids to track, trace, and dominate society. We as a human species need to wake up to this and say no to it. We've also got a lot of NSA news. Bitcoin exchange, MT Gox disappears in blow to virtual currency. That is in Reuters. And another report here, the virtual currency's value plummets after hundreds of thousands of Bitcoins are apparently stolen in cyber attack. I mean, Bitcoin, ladies and gentlemen, is a giant fraud, is a giant scam. And I've been warning people up front, if you want to get involved in a bubble and ride it up and get out at the right time, that's your issue. I don't do stuff like that. I don't invest in the stock market, even though I know how to do it and have done some tests and been successful before. Because fundamentally, it's a fraud. We need to build real economies. And I'm not judging if you got involved in Bitcoin, but don't be mad at me when they start trying to arrest people that have been involved in it and having the IRS grab your wages and all sorts of things. They want to promote this to discredit private cryptocurrencies that are the answer. I don't like that we don't know where the provenance of it came from. There's no vetting. There's no transparency. My gut has told me to run, not walk from Bitcoin. So we can discuss Bitcoin today as well. Here is the toll-free number to join us. It is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. We will get you up and on the air on this live Tuesday edition. First-time callers, long-time callers, total free for all, 800-259-9231. And then when I start the next hour, I'm going to get into the really big issue. FDA weighs risk of three-person embryo fertilization. Folks, it's already been going on for a long time. Cloning's been going on for a long time. I want to break this down for everybody at the start of the next hour. And then we'll just continue on with your phone calls and a bunch of special reports from the nightly news the last few days that are really, really important. But you know, as I said, most hosts, if the power was off at their studio, we have the backup network who can run backup out of Minnesota. And then every once in a while, every couple of years, they have a problem. We have backup here. So we are somewhat redundant for even big-time media. We're about as redundant as they are. Again, no video feeds today with the power being off. And it shows you how tenuous our whole civilization and situation is when you realize how dependent we are on the electrical grid. When you realize the electrical grid is under attack, it's not being upgraded, it's not being repaired in many areas, that's on record. The infrastructure across the board, roadways, rail beds for trains, transportation across the board, but our power plants, they've dozens of them around the country that were completed. One of them cost $3 billion in Corpus Christi. They did not allow it to be opened under Obama the last 6 years, and so now they're opening new plants in Mexico that just spew totally dirty mercury, you name it out, just straight up coal stacks, turning turbines to create steam, to turn turbines to create electrical power. And now China, Mexico, India, they're just building power plants everywhere. They're totally dirty. And we're having more than 500 power plants now shut down under Lord Obama. And scores of them that were brand new were never allowed to open, that nothing comes out of the top of them but carbon dioxide that plants literally breathe and then create oxygen from, part of the carbon cycle, and water vapor. That's why they've listed carbon as a pollutant, even though the Congress wouldn't pass a law saying it. They've listed carbon dioxide because once they do that, they have a corner on the entire global market. And I know I talk a lot about that. It's just that it's such a big deal to know that 51% until 5 years ago, 6 years ago, of our power came from coal. And it's now, depending on the region, 30%, 45%, and going down. And power prices are just absolutely exploding. And that really hurts Americans. And I don't like poverty. You know, I was going to see my uncle before he died a few months ago, back in early January, and I pulled over with my son in Waco on the way to East Texas to Luby's on a weekday where I took off the radio show and drove there. And I stood there in line when Luby's opened at 11 a.m., a cafeteria, watching all these old women. And I've been going to Luby's since I was knee-high to a grasshopper, since I was born in Dallas, Texas. They have them all over the state. And so I go to Luby's every few weeks. And my kids like it, so I people watch. And I sat there and I watched all these old people who couldn't even afford the Luann platter. The Luann platter is from King of the Hill. She's named Luann from the Luann platter, and Luby's is in King of the Hill. Little Texas stuff that Mike Judge wrote into it. But to make a long story short, it physically is painful for me to be buying whatever food I want and not having to worry about it because I'm middle class, and then to be watching working class men and women and old women mainly who literally were stressed out when they were paying for their food and really worried about it, trying to go out once a week with their friends at the cafeteria, trying to just live like, you know, working class people, and they can't even do it. That irritates me to a great extent. And then I get physically angry by the injustice of the deindustrialization, the offshoring of our jobs, NAFTA and GATT written to shut down our industry, the devaluation of our currency. And I think about all the family I've got that used to be middle class, that now work 2-3 jobs and can't even barely pay for their children to have new shoes. And I just see the poverty creeping in everywhere. And then I know it's all by design, Cloward and Piven, all by design to bankrupt us and put us on food stamps. And Obamacare is meant to make you go from 40 hours to less than 30. And they tell you now, they tell the businesses, this came out last year, oh, just tell your employees go on food stamps. Walmart tells their employees. In fact, their strategy is pay their employees at a level where they qualify for assistance. I mean, what type of economy is that, folks? It's a broken, domesticated, enslaved, captured people. 800-259-9231. We're going to come back and just free for all your phone calls. And I don't care how good your call is. I'm going to try to go to the next person so we get everybody in. So just start your engines, get ready. I'm going to go to you. And then I'll get into all the news in the second hour, shake the show up a little bit here today. But again, it's kind of cozy to not have the lights on all around me and not have the cameras all on and to not, it's kind of old school. I like it. You know, I thought about maybe once a week doing the radio show without the cameras on. Of course, the nightly news will always be cameras on because that's TV based, but it's just very reassuring. This reminds me of my first 8 years or so on air when I was just radio, not the last 10 or 11. We've been simulcasting video at prisonplanet.tv. I think this song says it all. I don't want any shackles on me. Not smart meters. Not forced inoculations.
Don't want no shackles on me.
Not national ID cards. Not NSA spy grids that are all illegal. Not financial shackles of offshore banks signing us onto their derivatives.
I sit down with Big Brother.
And then telling us that we're a debtor nation.
RFIDs.
Yeah, I got the blues about tyranny. What about you?
Got the blues about my freedom. Got the blues about tyranny.
A lot of evil in the world right now, folks. It's getting worse.
I got the blues about my freedom. Got the blues about tyranny.
Better thank your lucky stars and the Lord above whenever you're got a good time in your life.
I sat down with Big Brother and the national ID.
I don't want a chip in my family, a chip in my wife.
Don't want a chip in my wallet, chip in my car. And if I want to travel, it's nobody's business how far. Don't want no shackles.
It's Jimmy Vaughn, no shackles.
Don't want no shackles on me.
Yeah, down with Big Brother.
I said shame on Big Brother, always tracking and tracing me.
Remember, you were kooky to say this a few years ago. Now it's just out in the open.
Don't want a chip in my mother, chip in my wife. A chip in my babies. Stay out of our life. Don't want.
Oh, they're
going to
put genetics into your baby through the GMO
don't
food.
Want no shackles on
and when
me.
You have genetic disorders, they're going to come in and genetically engineer you to live.
I sat down with Big Brother.
All the back doors built in.
No more slavery.
No more slavery.
Play it for me, baby.
All right, I said I'd go to your phone calls, and I want to go to your phone calls. Chase, Travis, Jeff, Lance, Truth Raider, Jimmy playing his guitar and actually singing that song is on YouTube somewhere. I know it's got a lot of views. We ought to repost that on Infowars.com. Jimmy Vaughn, no shackles on me. See if the guys can find it online and repost it to Infowars.com. We may have the power partially out here at the studios, but Infowars.com, PresentPlanet.com, Real Alex Jones on Twitter. It's all up and steaming ahead. Let's go ahead without further ado and talk to Chase in Texas. Chase, thanks for calling. You're on the air.
Well, thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Man, that's some good beer drinking music right there, bro, but it's too early to get started. I wanted to, in the past, I've always been negative about this stuff, man, but I'm starting in my spirit to be of good cheer about it because In my opinion, I think this whole New World Order, it's going to be about as successful as a spruce goose was for Howard Hughes. They're going to put a lot into it. It's going to get off the ground for a little bit, but it's going to be put to the hangar of history. We're going to look back at the species as our species and go, damn, we can't go down that road no more.
Well, that's what the Bible says. They'll have their world system for 1 hour.
Yes, sir, you are right. And secondly, I want to say, folks in Texas, get out and vote. I'm not going to say who to vote for. Just do your homework. Main thing is we got to get Cornyn out of there.
Yeah, who do you think's good, Stockman?
Yes, sir, I voted for Stockman. And I voted for Patterson. I voted for Medina for comptroller.
So you voted for Patterson for governor?
No, lieutenant governor.
Yeah, lieutenant governor. That's what I meant.
And governor, of course, I voted for Abbott. I don't even want to. I ain't even going to say her name. And thirdly, sir, I got some of that male vitality. Oh, my God. I've been pole vaulting out of bed, man.
No, listen, I went to Dr. Grip and I said, I want the ultimate purified, concentrated, healthy herbs known to make you release your own testosterone. And I mean, I'm not kidding in the ad. I have to take it every other day or take a half dose because I already obviously have a lot of male stamina and aggression. But women, again, it's really female vitality too. It does the same thing to women. In fact, it makes women even more vibrant. We're going to label it for women and change a little bit and come out with a brand for women. But quite frankly, that's going to be a gimmick. But if women want it to be pink bottle and be a little bit different, fine. Super Male Vitality is even better for women, Dr. Group has found. And it took us 6 months to develop it, and it took us months to actually get the herbs that are totally non-GMO. And I didn't mean to go into a plug. Describe what it's done for you.
Well, man, I mean, I just been being lethargic and coming in and working and just, it's like you get your second wind, almost. And
well, by the way, my buddy Shane Steiner is a power lifter, and he'd gotten really big, so he kind of, the last 6 months, went into a cardio deal to lose weight, just to see if he could do that, and he lost about 30 pounds. And we said, well, let's see what Super Male Vitality does. And he goes, Alex, I know you sell good stuff, but all right, I'll try some herbs, see what it does. He came in here and got like 10 bottles a month ago, and he said, oh my gosh, I can't believe this. And he's just exploding in size. He says he's never had workouts this good on any other supplements. It's just, it's not hype, folks. We bring you high-quality products to fund the operation that we believe help people. InfoWarsLife.com for the Super Male Vitality, the Fluoride Shield, and, of course, the Survival Shield, proprietary Nation Iodine, InfoWarsLife.com. All right, we'll be back with no more plugs. I'm going to go right to your calls. Waging war on corruption, crashing to the lies and disinformation. Here for now, forever gone. Seasons don't fear the reaper.
Seasons don't fear the reaper. Nor do the wind, the sun, or the rain.
I don't fear the reaper.
Come on, baby, don't fear the reaper. Baby, take my hand.
Monday through Friday, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central Standard Time, we're here live, a beacon of liberty transmitting worldwide. I am your host, Alex Jones, and we are taking your phone calls right now. I come to you from captured former Texas in the old Republic, FEMA Region 6. This is an emergency transmission. If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance.
Valentine is done. Here, but now they're gone.
That's a beautiful song, isn't it?
Romeo and Juliet are together in eternity. Romeo and Juliet. 40,000 men.
You'll be with Julius Caesar. And Mahatma Gandhi. And Martin Luther King. And Martin Luther. Don't fear the reaper, Ray Kurzweil. You believe you're going to become God, merging with the machines. You believe by throwing your humanity away, you will become enlightened and empowered. Your Faustian pack will only bring you down. All right, folks, let's go back to your phone calls. I've really done a new record, 35 minutes in the broadcast. I've taken one call. The old days, I could take like 50 calls in an hour. Never been able to do it in like a decade. Let's go ahead and talk to Travis in Washington. Travis, you're on the air. Thanks for calling.
Hey, Alex. How you doing?
Good, brother. What you calling about today?
No, I just want to give you an analogy, buddy. I love you. Everything you bring up is true head on, but you never really seem to... Here's the analogy. You remind me of somebody that's really hardworking with a machete in his hand cutting down weeds, but you're not going after the root. And the root is, in 1867, they made this a corporation, U.S. corporation. And every person that's born into this corporation is filed under it. And when you refer yourself as a person, you are not talking being a human. You're talking being part of this corporation. And this corporation is ran by a president, like the banks. And that president, of course, he's above all the laws of the banks. And that's the way they look at every one of us, Alex. And if that root is still there after you cut down all these weeds, they still own that root. They still own this nasty corporation. They'll do whatever they want.
Well, I mean, it is true with the amendments that came in that supposedly ended slavery. It created a new type of citizen that's a ward of the state. And there is a lot of truth to that. And then there's the private Federal Reserve that's been operating for 100 years and 3 months, dominating and manipulating the economy. And so it is all based on fraud. Just like they say every year, it's the law to take vaccines. There is no law to take vaccines to attend school. It's a mass criminal lying fraud. You have to go in their office and say there is no law. You have a waiver to the policy. But I don't even have to fill out the waiver. And then they will go, oh, okay, you're right. Here's the waiver. It's all fraud. There's just so much patriot mythology, though, that if you just go in and revoke the bond and point out that your birth certificate's been used as collateral, which it actually is to the IMF and World Bank, that's true, they don't care. It's force du jour or force majeure. They're just operating by the power of the gun. As Mao Zedong said, all power grows out of the barrel of a gun. That's why they want our guns, to complete our journey into slavery. But yes, they did not free the black folks after the Civil War. They simply made everyone a ward of the state and inducted us into the system. And then with the Federal Reserve Act of 1913, War Powers Act of 1933, they set up the state police that are really an international OC, Organization of Economic Cooperative Development, combine. And we have been bankrupted into that. That's how they're appointing the presidents of Greece and Italy and other places now and signing them onto their debt. That's how they're doing this. They're in the Economist magazine announcing that they're going to privatize basically all the public lands and give it to select corporations. But not because they even bailed us out, because we've been signed on to those corporations, those banks' debts. Because we've been signed on to their debt, we then go into debt to them. It's incredible.
Alex, that's without our consent. Are you still talking to me?
Yes, I am. And it's all done without our consent, and it's all fraud.
Right, and you're talking about amendments to a constitution, and the constitution was a contract between the government of Washington, D.C. to run the states, not us humans, not us.
No, I agree. Humans. The Bill of Rights and Declaration of Independence, as well as especially the Ninth Amendment, is saying that all the powers are reserved to the people, and that everything listed here, we have a lot more rights than just that.
Well, that's why they threw away the 13th Amendment. It's all paper and it's all crap. It was all funded by the European powers that came over here. They had stocks.
Yeah, I mean, let's be clear. The founders weren't perfect, and none of it was perfect from the beginning, and they had to sue for peace and then make some deals with King George III. But this system is under attack because it's anathema to the monopoly capitalist, the monopoly gangsters. And so our real Republican form of government with the Bill of Rights, Declaration of Independence, and Constitution, if properly implemented by the people, is the best system ever created. People blame our system and say that capitalism failed. This isn't capitalism. This is crony Federal Reserve picking the winners, fraud. And that's what I'm here to expose. But I hear you, and I appreciate your call, Travis. That's why I love the grab bag calls, the wild card calls. They're just all over the map today. Let's go ahead and talk to Jeff in Texas, then Lance, Truth Raider, Richard, and others. Go ahead.
Hello, Alex.
Hey, Jeff.
Hey, man, I got a question for you. I'm a disabled veteran, and from what I understand about the Ryan Murray budget bill, they cap the income of cost of living allowances for veterans and senior citizens. Is that true? Do you know about that?
Yes. There's all sorts of cutting veterans benefits and cutting disabled veterans benefits, and they're getting ready to scale back on the pension funds of officers. So it's going to be a nightmare situation. Unlimited trillions to foreign banks and derivatives, but they're going to cheat and falsify the contracts by law and are moving now and have all sorts of articles in the Army Times and stuff about taking and cutting back the pensions of the armed services veterans.
Yeah, it's just not fair to me. I was trying to get Social Security disability for 10 years. And what it is they keep you in the system for 10 years, and after that, you're no longer eligible, just so all the veterans that are out there coming back from the wars know if they're disabled, they'll try to keep you in the system for 10 years, and then after 10 years, you're no longer eligible to even apply.
Well, that's right. I've had veterans' rights groups on. The VA spends like half its money on PR and propaganda, and it's there to keep an eye on the obsolete weaponry that they see the humans as, that they want to spike like an old cannon. And there's some good people in the system that still try to do a good job, but it's extremely predatory. I mean, look at how they announce veterans as the number one enemy of Homeland Security with a straight face in the news. And the new army that's going to be domestic as they scale back worldwide is pointed directly at anybody that is a real American. I mean, it's Twilight Zone level.
Well, I'm doing what I can to keep myself occupied. I might be disabled, but I'm a recording artist. SRV was a friend of mine. A lot of your friends I've met before, and I'm sure we've ran in the same circles as far as musicians go, but that's what I do, man. I play music, and I'm real good at it, and the blues. I love the blues.
Well, we played some of that earlier for you, brother. God bless you, and I appreciate your call. Yeah, I don't want to get into complex economic discussions here, but we can build, with the technology we have and automation and factories, we can build any society and any culture that we want. It's basically unlimited what we can do. And Dr. Bob Bowman, who was a nuclear physicist, wrote about this and we had him on. The fact that with automation and the systems we have, we should be working 2 days a week and the rest of it doing art and literature and uplifting more needy people. And the globalists talk about this. They talk about how the Federal Reserve wants to keep the economy from, quote, overheating and growing faster than 3.5%. Well, our economy grew at 10% for most of our history until the Federal Reserve came in. So what they want is stagnation. They want feudalism. And they want that on record. And if anybody deserves to get their health care and to get their pensions, it's the service people. But notice the World War I marchers, the bonus marchers, Eisenhower, to his discredit, along with MacArthur, they were both young colonels, you know, killed a bunch of veterans in D.C. that have been camped out for months, demanding that they get their World War I bonus. And these were people that had arms and legs blown off. And it wasn't even that big of a sum. And what they got was army tanks and bullets and horses. And MacArthur and Eisenhower, who weren't bad guys compared to our elites today, notice were elevated to running everything because they would kill U.S. veterans. So just a little factoid that most people are not aware of right there. Truth Raider, you're on the air worldwide. Thanks for calling.
The Truth Raider's on the march. The Empire's on the run. Live with Alex Jones from Austin, Texas, in the dark.
That's right. You got a really good voice over a telephone, buddy.
Thank you very much. I'm praying that something will come along in the future that I have my opportunity. But we'll see what happens if I ever get into radio or become an NX broadcaster for you, perhaps in the Northwest. Maybe you could use...
Well, what I suggest is if you build it, they will come. I would start out with Access Television because that has pretty good audiences and nobody uses it. People, if it's interesting, will tune through and stop. Then I'd use those tapes to get a local radio show, or I'd start your own radio show on YouTube every day, do an hour or so, and then you'll end up getting a radio show. But people are always waiting for it to happen, yet you have to go out and do it.
Exactly. Okay, today I want to talk about two topics, the electronic disassociation that we have in society, and number two, the slow and insidious transition into a socialist society here in America.
Well, go ahead.
Okay, electronics, cell phones, iPads, iPods, wherever you look. You see people buried... their face is buried in these electronic gadgets, and it's disassociated people. I go by by conspiracies that I can prove, and I've seen this.
No, it's on record with the wavelengths and all of it. The language is shrinking. People aren't communicating. They're becoming total loners, and they're living inside their devices instead of living in the real world. It's a very serious phenomenon that's being done by design.
Yes, I see that. And the insidious transition into a social society. How they're doing this? Well, I've seen this for over 10 years, and it's starting to come here to the Northwest, but we're having an Hispanicization of our country. Now, I have nothing against Hispanic people. Most of them are pretty good people, but they're bringing the wrong ones here to our country.
Well, it is true that a lot of the criminals and dregs of Latin America are coming here, gaming the system, and then they keep extreme nationalistic, anti-white, anti-black racism, and that's a minority, but it's a large minority, and then it supposedly has to be overlooked and ignored and is cute, and it's meant to break the country up and create more balkanization for the North American Union, because, again, they merged the three states into one, but then they're going to break things up into sub-regions within the larger unions.
Yes, indeed. The best Mexicans I've ever known, the ones that went through the process. I had a good friend that went through the process of immigrating here, and he went through a 10 to 12 year excruciating process of always having to fill out applications and everything he had to go through.
No. I mean, good hardworking people, they make it impossible. I don't even care if you're from Western Europe, wherever it's at, or Mexico. And then the criminals just come in and get legalized. I know, it's amazing. I appreciate your call. I mean, look, folks, you can't go to Mexico and demand to have your baby for free or demand welfare. They'd laugh at you. And nobody else does this but Western Europe and the United States. And it's designed to break the countries up. And they can politically correct, go, oh, no, it's for peace and to diversify things. No, it's being done as a political tool, and everybody knows it. Let's go ahead and talk to Lance in Kansas. Lance, you're on the air.
Hello, Alex. How are you doing today, sir?
I'm doing all right, brother.
Well, thank you. I'd like to, first of all, you hate to hear thanks, but I'd like to thank you for pointing me in the right direction to wake me up. Not necessarily for waking me up, but thank you for presenting information to me that I did not know existed, and giving me the ability to research it myself and use my own brain.
Crime.
Yes. Use my own brain to figure out what is right and what is wrong. And I live in Lawrence, Kansas, and I just wanted to comment on Ted Nugent last night and how whatever her name was would deviate from his points and keep on her point at trying to get Ted Nugent to admit that he was, a white trash, potty mouthed, just a hater of all races. And he would point out that Obama's murdering people. Hillary doesn't care that four Americans got killed in Benghazi. But that's not important because Ted Nugent called them potty mouth names.
And listen, the issue is it's all about the establishment setting the parameters of values and then lecturing us all day. And obviously Nugent's just using this to get himself more fame and fortune, which I think is fine, and it's backfiring on them. But the so-called dinosaur mainstream media doesn't have any power anymore. And as soon as people realize that and just laugh at them, it goes away. All they've got is race politics. And they are the ones that, did people get mad at Bill Maher last week when he called Matt Drudge a stupid cracker? You know, I've got MSNBC calling white people names, white people doing it. They're only trying to stir up race. In fact, let me just mention this article since you raised it. This is out of the Daily Sheeple, but it was first reported by WHIO Television. This is up on Infowars.com. A Bible stopped the bullets when a white man was targeted by young black polar bear hunters. And it goes on to describe it as an expansion on the knockout game to go and knock out unsuspecting crackers. And the new game, the police say the bus driver, this is a WHIO news, police say the bus driver is lucky to be alive after three black teenagers stabbed and shot him. A Bible over the bus driver's heart stopped two bullets and allowed him to fight off a knife attack from his assailants. One additional bullet stuck him in the leg. The teens also stabbed him in the arm. The attack came in the morning at 5:30 when the driver stopped his bus because of mechanical difficulties. As he was outside the bus assessing how to fix the problem, the three suspects came up to him and said they were going to shoot a polar bear today. And it just goes on right there that the Bible saved him. They were ages 15 to 18. My issue is if white groups were doing this, it would be on every channel, and they would be saying whites collectively are to blame. I'm not saying blacks are collectively to blame, but there are large subcultures of young black males that viciously hate white people and viciously go out and attack them. I don't blame everybody because of that. But again, these type of news stories get shut down and covered up. So I appreciate your call. Good to hear from you, Lance. Frank, Richard, Kevin, 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. It's radio, old style, no video feed today. We're turning lemons into lemonade from the InfoWars Command Center, deep in the heart of Texas, prisonplanet.tv. Stay with us. Every move you make, every breath you take, the loving offshore banks that run our government are watching you. And they're totally cold-blooded, and they want to make you poor so that you're so dumbed down and working so hard you don't know why you have no political rights and no future. They use poverty on record as a tool of social control. And we'll be like every other nation soon. Our wealth, our language, our IQs, our health is pouring out like a man who's had his legs chopped off with huge meat cleavers. The New World Order creates poverty and pain. Globalism, world government is a fraud. And I don't want to be a slave of these people. I want to be free and build a better world. We're going to continue with your calls into this segment and the next, and then I'm going to break down what's starting to be big news, and I'm glad it is big news. They're going to come out with these three-parent children. I want to break down exactly what this really means, ladies and gentlemen. That is all coming up in the next hour and more. I mentioned this yesterday, but I'm going to cover it today on the polio-like illness found in five California children. And I know I had this yesterday in the stack. Will you guys pull me the mainstream news articles about the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and their vaccines paralyzing the kids? Well, I guess almost all the power's off. A major transformer blew up in this area of Austin, and so we're on backup generator and can't even get on most of our computers. It doesn't matter. People can look it up for themselves. Briefly, what's not down is InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. And when you go there, you can see the online shopping cart. We have the new Molon Labe. I think it's the best Molon Labe. Come and take it. Spartan M4 shirt out there. Victory for the Second Amendment. My design. It's up there on InfoWarsStore.com. It is the best seller ever. Right after the Mass Murderers Agree Gun Control Work shirt that I designed 16 years ago. That's our first t-shirt that we still sell. And by the way, the Molon Labe shirts are all made in America. Madein1776.com will lead you right to the Made in America apparel area and InfoWarsStore.com, but both places will take you there. And you heard the rave review for Super Male Vitality. We're running into next week the 15% off as an introduction to it, the Super Male Vitality that just really helps reverse the estrogen mimickers that are blocking normal testosterone and so much more. It's designed to make you feel like a natural male should. And believe me, it's not hype, folks. It's powerful, concentrated herbs that I can't even take the full dose on. I've got friends that take more than the regular dose. Consult your doctor if you have any questions. InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Okay, let's go ahead and go to Richard in Mississippi. Richard, thanks for calling.
Good morning, Alex. How are you?
Good, brother. Go ahead. What's on your mind today?
First off, let me just say we still have some of the Second Amendment in force down here in Mississippi. We do have open carry of sidearms, and I encourage all fellow Mississippians to make sure they exercise that right wherever they go.
Because an unexercised right doesn't exist.
Absolutely. I called today about the situation in the Ukraine. I keep hearing the one word over and over, Nazis. I hear the deposed president saying that they are facing the return of Nazism. The new angelic leader with her braided hair, Tymoshenko, came from a party, a far right-wing party called the Fatherland Party.
No, and it's being funded by George Soros. And again, they're not right-wing in the sense of private property guns. they're right-wing in the sense of they're anti-Russian and anti-Slav and think they're subhuman.
Absolutely. And last year in December, when our illustrious senator from Arizona, John McCain, took Democrat Chris Murphy over to meet with the leaders of the Svoboda Party, the Freedom Party.
Hold on. You know what you're talking about. I'm going to come back to you. Stay there. Second hour coming up. Don't hang up. He's done his research, yeah. And again, I'm not romanticizing the Russians or the Eastern Ukraine. The point is the West is starting this. Morally, that's wrong. And George Soros is quarterbacking the whole thing. What does that tell you about it? George Soros is a piece of crap. And,
thank
by the way, is a Nazi as well.
GCN.
And just, you can never get rid of these people.
Visit GCNlive.com
right, stay with us.
Today.
Big Brother. Mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We're now into hour number two, and we're video free today because of a major power outage in the area. We're on backup generators, audio only, but hey, that takes us back to our roots. There's a study out showing that you can think better in a darker room. And I tell you, it's assaulting to have TV lights pointed at you all the time. I like being in here with just one light on. It's very restful, like I used to do the radio show back in the past without the simulcast of TV. But we're taking your phone calls right now. Coming up in the next segment, I'm going to delve into the merger of three humans into one. You thought clones were bad news, folks. Wait until we break all this down. FDA weighs risk of three-person embryo fertilization. Recap and start over. Richard, Mississippi, you were bringing up the Ukraine situation. Look, both sides have issues with each other, and I'm sure the government was corrupt. Most governments are corrupt, but it was elected. The point is they already overthrew the government in 2004, then that got reversed. George Soros, the State Department, Hillary Clinton, John McCain, they started this whole thing during the Olympics so that the Russians wouldn't want to respond during the first takeover. The Russians are on record now saying they're sending troops into Crimea nearby. This is a serious situation. Go ahead and make your points you were starting to get into there, Richard.
Yes, thank you. As far as Crimea goes, that's the Russians' only option, is to annex Crimea and to save the ethnic Russians who live in that region from probably what we would see, what we had in Bosnia, ethnic cleansing. They've the coup d'etat that took place, the new government, quote-unquote, has already voted to outlaw the Russian language today in western Ukraine, and they have no remorse for anyone who sided with the former Soviet Union. The far right-wing parties as a collective that came together with George Soros and the EU and the United States started out as the Organization of Ukrainian Nationalists, who formed after World War II to collaborate with the Nazis to slaughter 60,000 Poles. And those folks have no love for Jewish people. They have no love for anyone who even has a hint.
And it shows how George Soros will literally work with anybody.
Well, absolutely. It defies logic that when...
Look at how they're funding Al-Qaeda to attack Syria. In Egypt. I mean, it's just, it's despicable.
And that gets to my question that I'm trying to get to with this background for you, is in USA Today, yesterday, they ran a photo of a protester, quote-unquote, wearing a World War II SS helmet. And the gist of the protest is not any type of independence for Ukraine, but to return fascist ideals to a region which they thought had them taken from
which
them.
Which is even more ridiculous because the EU is going to open the borders up to immigration from all over the world. It's just, look, those right-wing people are idiots. I wouldn't even call them right-wing because they were connected to the Nazis. I'd call them fascist slash socialist. And because that's, fascism and socialism are almost the same thing.
The Russians will annex Crimea in order to preserve, you know, obviously their heritage and the largest naval base that they have.
Yeah, I think that's going to happen. In fact, it's being reported up on Infowars.com out of Zero Hedge, Joel Skousen. By the way, let's get Joel Skousen on about what's happening. I want to talk to him this week about Ukraine. It's on. Putin deploys troop battalion. Russians raise flag over Ukraine, Republic of Crimea. And I'll cover some of that coming up after I get into this cloning news. That's really what it is, straight ahead. Good to hear from you, caller. Thank you, Richard. Kevin, Matt, Kyle, Simon, 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. Your phone calls are coming up straight ahead. I'm doing a good job today of taking phone calls. I get a gold star and a lollipop later. And something even more delicious.
The Genesis Communications Radio Network proudly presents The Alex Jones Show, because there's a war on for your mind.
I want to be clear here. I am not anti-technology. Technology generally is neutral, but historically it has a lot of bad side effects as well. And examples of that are obviously legion. But I remember being on the radio 18, 19 years ago and reading BBC News articles about how they'd already cloned humans in laboratories. They had just killed the embryos before they developed to any major size. And then I saw mention in the Washington Post and other publications about how in places like Costa Rica, they had created laboratories, and the word is brought human clones to term. The word is that in the 1940s, some of the Nazis were able to clone rabbits. Now, of course, in the last 20 years, they've cloned sheep, they've cloned rabbits, the list goes on and on. The issue here is that, well, there's many issues, but the larger issue is the globalists are social engineers. And they hypothesized DNA in the 1850s under Galton, the father of eugenics, who also invented the strictures and the science of biometrics. And it has been eugenics in the last 160 years or so that is the governing undergirder of philosophy of social engineering and societal architecture. And my greatest goal is to simply get listeners to realize there is social engineering, there is social architecture going on, and the people that are implementing it and the people that are carrying it out are extremely intelligent, extremely neurotic, and extremely anti-general public, and are on big power trips and believe that they are going to be able to seize the future by walling off society in an arrested, shut down, stagnated technological system, while in government and corporate and university reservations, they will be able to build the next level civilization with the life extension technologies, the interstellar travel, and all the things of that we think of as the future. And so that decision has been made to give us Justin Bieber and all the rest of the mindless hype in the NFL. And while we're busy obsessing over those little factoids that don't affect the establishment, they are building the new world around us. And the fact that the public is so dumbed down and so distracted and so already raised in front of a television set from birth, the establishment literally has written thousands and thousands of white papers and books admitting all this. Google's head of technology came out 2 days ago and said, rise of the robots, end of the humans, 2030. And that we'll be like a bug that they just step on. Now, I mean, he was saying that 20 years ago. The issue is that he's actually racially running Google. And it's not about the trillions of dollars now, folks. It's about these guys never dying. But see, before they can develop those technologies, they have to create a world government and restrict our access to healthcare and bring in the death panels so that you don't get access to it. And you've got to also understand they're not going to let you know about the real medicine and technological systems they've created. That is going to be closely held under national security and is closely held under national and global corporate security. I mean, mean, look at Dick Cheney. He survived with a heart pump for 2 years. Nobody else could survive a year. He looks great now, got a heart transplant. And if you don't know that he got advanced technologies to be able to do that, he runs around giving speeches claiming he didn't, you're a fool. And so this is the ultimate discrimination we're talking about. Not letting the general population have access to all of this. Not even letting us know that there have been space planes in orbit for 30 years. Not letting folks know there have been giant DU meteor gun platforms in space for 30 years. Not letting the public know that they've been cloning humans since the 1950s. Not letting the public know they had underground base facilities building cyborgs in the 1980s. They tried to hire my dad and like 10 other top dentists in Dallas to be paid $500,000 a year when I was like 12 years old. He sat around the dinner table saying, well, this is classified, but honey, blah, blah, blah. You know, they won't tell me what it is, but it's cybernetics. And it's probably, you know, putting, hidden electronics and things in special forces is basically what he'd been told. And I'm not trying to impress you folks. They tried to hire a whole bunch of oral surgeons that were pioneers in implants like my dad was. I mean, what do you think they're putting in spies' jaws, spies' skulls? He was told, I mean, literally, he was going to be in Maryland in underground facilities creating cyborgs. You're not in Kansas anymore, ladies and gentlemen. I want to just get all this across to all of you so that you understand that. And so that you realize that all of these technologies we are tested upon with all the new genetic therapies and the new endocrine therapies and the new DNA therapies, and the viral therapies, we are tested on. That's why they call the medical system in the West a practice, because you're never perfecting what you're doing. You are practicing on the patients. Just 150 years ago in England, the general public did not have access to doctors, period, unless you were in a medical facility and had been signed over for medical experimentation. You were then practiced upon so that the elite doctors could then go and actually carry out the medicine on the elite. So this isn't something new that we're practiced on. We've always been practiced on. We've always been seen as animals, whether it was Japan or ancient France or ancient Russia. We are animals. The elite are gods. Every culture has an upper caste that says everyone else is an animal under them as the excuse to keep people like animals so you can control them, because humans, Homo sapiens sapien predator. What's the word in Latin for predator? Because that's what I would really call the elite. Homo sapiens sapien tyrannus. Homo sapiens sapien tyrant. Homo sapiens sapien vampirus. Homo sapiens sapien parasitis. These are the names of the elite. And my biggest problem with them is, sure, there's dumbed down, lazy, evil, unwashed masses. They're always out there. And I understand the elite have got, I mean, I've seen them, I've been around them. I mean, they are really smart people. Their eyes twinkle with demonic intelligence. My only issue is the crime of trying to dumb everybody down so you can manage people shows that you're not really as elite as you say you are. You believe your social Darwinism gives you this authorization to dominate and kill and rule over everyone. And the mere fact that you're in charge means that you have a right to rule over everyone. But the very sciences of control that you're bringing forward are blowing back on your children. I've run into some of the most elite families in the world growing up. Some of my crew have grown up around some of the most elite families, some of the biggest names out there, and they literally are totally unhappy, screwed up people. The path you're going down is not a good one. Now, I've prefaced all of this with just some basic background. It's such a big area, it's hard to get into. But I saw this article yesterday, and I mentioned it. There's a new one out today on Bloomberg. The stories are up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com right now. Here it is out of Bloomberg. Dad may join two moms for disease-free designer babies. You're that disease-free. Talk about selling it. Disease-free. You're going to be disease-free now. Just let us get in there and change the embryo and put other people's DNA in, which they can now basically nanotech and create artificially. and put whatever Trojan horses, whatever programs they want into there, just like all the Monsanto crops and the rest of it, that'll have 8 stacked traits. And then they go in and look at them and they find other traits and people sue them. And they declare national security and proprietary. And the courts rule, no, you can't look at what's in that Monsanto corn or that Monsanto canola or that Monsanto soybean. They're stacking other stuff in there. If they do it to all the electronics and they do it to all the secret testing, of course they're doing it in the genetic engineering. And to change one genetic trait, it then randomly, when you reproduce the next generation, creates hundreds if not thousands of other random mutations. So here's the deal. Once they start randomly changing people to get rid of some predisposition for cancer or for going blind or for leukemia, whatever the case is, that when you try to have kids later, the person that's been altered, you're not going to be able to, and that's the holy grail for the establishment, you're going to have to go back in to their system and have them, quote, take your genetics and the other people's genetics and create the new designer human that is not really your son or daughter. It will be a laboratory product. And in the year 2014, this has been going on for a long time, and when we come back, I want to read over these articles for you so you can hear this. And, of course, the FDA board is going to authorize it. And it's already being done in China. China, 10 years ago, was feeding their troops human milk that comes out of the udders of cows. 15 years ago, you could buy glow-in-the-dark monkeys in South Korea and in Hong Kong that are part jellyfish. 20 years ago, they were getting secret body armor. The program's public, but how they make it secret, with goats that are part spider whose milk produces Spider-Man web. And I would cover it then and literally have people threaten me on the street saying I was a liar. Because it was a culture shock for them. They couldn't believe that was happening. Well, now it's just passe. The dam is broken. Okay, they're spider goats. Okay, they got monkeys that are part jellyfish that glow in the dark and cats and dogs you can buy. I could buy and have it shipped and get it through quarantine after a few months, and I could have in the studio a glowing Labrador Retriever. Glows blue in the dark. Okay, see, we're not in Kansas anymore, folks. And so you need to understand, right beneath the surface is a 35 to 40-year advanced technological civilization that is about to roll out genetic engineering in the food where no one's going to be able to have children. You'll then have to go to them to have your kids, but they won't be your kids. It'll be an engineered Microsoft product. Coming up, folks, your phone calls and a ton of other news. Look, I just see myself on Team Humanity, and I think people should know the decisions that have been made and what's being set up for everybody, and that there literally is a national security breakaway worldwide corporate civilization that, in their own words, have endangered the human and planetary biosphere to such an extent that they've built giant animal, plant, seed vaults and emergency DNA, RNA vaults all over the world under the UN in the middle of nowhere, all over the planet. And they're absolutely irrevocably changing our DNA. I mean, it's on record that the major GMO crops kill the honeybees. It's on record that they cause genetic mutations off the charts with near total sterilization in guinea pigs, rats, and mice, and monkeys within 3 generations. And it's designed to hurt us. And you can see what they've done. You can see the IQ dropping. You can see the test scores dropping. You can see the cancer rates skyrocketing. I mean, people ask why I'm not worried about being killed. I mean, what is the point here? The average cop, the average military person, the average FBI agent, the average bureaucrat, the average politician, the average school teacher, the average factory worker, the average cowboy, the average auto parts person, they're good people. They just have been brought up with television. Television allowed government for the first time ever to totally create a false reality and accelerate social engineering and put people into it. They've been taking everybody's blood worldwide in the West, any Western-controlled country since 1973, 41 years. I told you about that first in the mid-90s. We got classified documents. They've now claimed patenting on everyone, claiming when you go in for a DNA-based treatment using your own DNA, they charge you hundreds of thousands. There's been Supreme Court cases on that. And I don't blame people 10 years ago would hear me talk about this and say, man, you're nuts. But now it's all out in the open. What are we going to do about it? And listen, you know, if I had a bunch of genetic disorders in my family and predisposed, if there was a pre-existing program where because of environmental stresses, something serious might manifest itself because I was predisposed, then I would want to know that information. And it started out with genetic testing, and it's no big deal. And, oh, there's not really any history, a little bit of cancer, a little bit of this and that, a little bit of heart disease. Now they say, oh, no, we're going to give you a disease-free baby, a designer disease-free. Well, you know that's not what they're going to deliver. They've been testing this on monkeys and other things in the new study, and the FDA is set tomorrow to meet to look at authorizing three parents. And, of course, people try to ban cloning because it has that social stigma, and rightfully so, of a brave new world, and what can they tweak in the clone? It really won't even end up being a clone, and does it have a soul? This is beyond that, where they call it three parents. No, what they do is they go into three different people's profiles, and then they basically go and fuse these systems in together, and heaven only knows what's going to happen. We know in plants, animals, and insects what happens with this. The next generation, and believe me, they're going to tell you, you're not going to be able to have kids properly after this. Because if you do, you're going to have to go back in and get it designered again. Because the first time, you're going to have hundreds of mutations. And the next generation, it's thousands of mutations. You can't go in the way science does it and just change major genetics and fuse them together and not have them then start mutating. Because you're designed to mutate. But you're designed to take the genetic code of all the men and women before you and then randomly display that for survival of the species. You're not meant to just giantly make changes in the genetic code that would have happened over hundreds of thousands of years and then manifested a new human. There's never been two mommies and one daddy. None of this has ever gone on. And it's a disaster with crops that are much simpler. It's a disaster with the salmon that's three times the size of the natural salmon, and they predict within 40 generations, that's 40 years, university studies, will extinct all natural salmon. It's already happening. They go out and they kill them. They go out and they swim past them. They go out and they eat their food. And so the globalists believe in the technological growth curve, though, that they've got to do this testing, and that they will advance so fast technologically. The analogy I read from Kurzweil or a decade ago, I forget which book it was that if we sent folks out with, say, nuclear-powered ramjet-type technology to go to Alpha Centauri's, and it took 35 years for a colony to get there, by the time that craft got halfway there, they would have light jump or warp capability, and you would have those ships launched after surpassing the colony ships that left before. So their argument is they're going to have enough advanced technology to clean all this stuff up. You guys can't even run a nuclear power plant, okay? You're not going to be able to handle this godlike technology. We'll be back. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. And I am he. Thank you so much for tuning in on this Tuesday, worldwide transmission, 25th day of February 2014. Your phone calls are coming up. Took a lot of calls in the last hour. And we will take a lot in this hour into the next hour and cover a ton of news we haven't gotten to yet. But the FDA, and this is already going on in other countries, getting ready to approving three-parent babies. Again, there's no debate here about the false advertising of saying it's you're going to be illness-free. There's no discussion of mutations down the road. There's no discussions of what type of new creature this creates, because this will not be a human by any stretch of the imagination. It will be a laboratory-manufactured creature. And as they bring in the toxic waste, as they bring in the GMO, as we lose our fertility, sperm counts are down over 85% in the West. Within another generation, you'll have almost total sterility. many areas of Latin America that had the highest fertility in the world. Now, see, there's plunging. It's being done by design. And you can argue, a lot of yuppies will say, well, there are too many people. Okay, but what about the secret program with the bisphenol A and the additives and the GMO? You're under attack, too. You don't just accept there's all these secret projects going on, many of which are actually public, and then just accept that our free will's been taken and that someone else is governing our future and our world. Look at the mainstream media dying. Look at their pertinence dying. Look at the New York Times not being relevant in their own words, not being able to get a story out there and have others covered it. We could easily discredit this technological terror that they're building, and we could easily take these technologies and actually test them properly and have a real public discourse about it and have it be open for genetic engineering to be public so they can't hide stuff inside of it. You think scientists that are going to let people have kids or get rid of pre-existing conditions by adding the genetics of a third parent into the mix are going to have any liability 15 years from now, 20 years from now, when one of these creatures has children and it's got three heads, literally? Have you seen the rats that eat Monsanto corn, third generation? They've got hair growing out their mouths, genitals on top of their heads. They look like something out of the Toxic Avenger. They have mutations post-utero, folks, unknown in mammals. I mean, listen, I don't know what's behind this in the final equation, and I do know what's behind it, but I can't say for sure. But let me just tell you this. It might as well be a black devil with a big old long forked tail, folks. Because let me tell you, this stuff's so diabolical, so twisted, so freaked out, so crazy. There's so many reams of documents and public statements and admissions and humanzies that have been created in labs in Georgia and Costa Rica. It's so crazy. What we know about, I don't even want to know what's going on that we're not aware of. And it's all in a Promethean mad dash for life extension, period. Let me read some of these articles, then I'm going to go to Kevin, and I'm going to go to Matt, and John, and Simon, and Duke, and others. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. If I sound different today for AM and FM affiliates, I undoubtedly do a better radio show when I'm in a dark room with one light bulb on above me, talking right into the microphone. It's very intimate. It's very relaxing. It's just like I'm here by myself, or I'm here talking to one friend. And I'm telling you what's really going on in my mind, and I'm calm. Television is more of a cool medium, but I've always gotten hotter on television. Radio's a hot medium, but I tend to be cooler on radio. And don't ask me why the psychology's that way, but with the power out in this area of Austin, they finally got it back on. We're on generator power until a few minutes ago. And I am just really enjoying not being on television right now. Maybe I should start doing maybe 2 hours TV and then maybe a third and fourth hour of radio, radio only. Stagger it. It would be because it's very relaxing. I like it. Continuing here with the news, Bloomberg. Dad may join two moms for disease-free designer babies. And the other pitch is for the LBGTDDY, whatever it's called, Lesbian Gay Coalition, they're saying, oh, two women can have a baby. How great. Yeah, cut men completely out of the equation. Do you have any idea genetically what that's going to do? Do you have any idea that women have mitochondria DNA that men don't have? I mean, you're really jacking with stuff then. It's like, shut up, racist. It's good for two women that love each other to have a baby. Yeah. And then that child is going to have all sorts of genetic problems, guaranteed. But they don't care. They're just going ahead with all this brave new world. A new technology aimed at eliminating genetic diseases. Oh, it's aimed at eliminating it. I thought it did, because there's the headline. Dad may join two moms for disease-free designer babies. Just because you have a predisposition to have cancer or heart disease, the reason cancer and heart disease are going up is because of the lifestyle, the chemicals, the biologicals, the GMOs that then cause your genetic predisposition. I have some trouble with that word for some reason today. disposition, your predisposition to manifest itself. That's like the best analogy is some crops of wheat are known to not be drought resistant, but to have high yields. Well, the wheat doesn't die because it genetically isn't good and has a disease. It just dies because it needs water. And yes, they've got wheat varieties that can use a lot less water because they've had their genetics manipulated. But it doesn't mean something was wrong with the other wheat. And a lot of times in studies, somebody that has one disease genetically will end up having a higher IQ and other attributes and gifts in other areas. It's a very complex situation. But to say, oh, we're all collectivized, government-run healthcare, we all pay for the insurance of everybody, we have to certify. That's where this is all going. We have to certify through the genetic bioethics boards with genetic testing under law, they're now passing all over the world, that you're not allowed to have a baby because we're not going to pay for the fact that they're predisposed and have a serious, statistical chance of developing breast cancer. And breast cancer is up, depending on the country, but the U.S. is number one in the world, England's number two, when we take the trophy from each other each year. It varies year to year. And it's because of the bisphenol A, the estrogen mimickers. I mean, if a girl's going into puberty when she's seven, she's supposed to be going into it when she's 14, double that age. And these women have the breast when they're 40 of 80-year-old women because you've been bathed in estrogen your whole life. That's why male genitalia across the board are smaller. Sperm counts are smaller. Boys' genitals are not dropping. Just like ovaries, they're up inside you till you hit puberty. And then they start to drop down. They're not dropping till 15, 20, 25, 30 years of age now because these are little girls. These are not men. And the brain develops differently in utero with these hormones, and you have a quasi-female brain. The women have hyper-female brains, hyper-feminine, just bathed in high levels of estrogen mimickers, and it's killing them. And these women that are predisposed, that if they get estrogen mimickers, and they admit this, and it grows these breast tumors, just like they have certain breeds of cows that they could feed the growth hormone to that wouldn't get cancer, and they knew other breeds you couldn't give it to. So they're trying to develop cows genetically that you can give all these hormones that won't die. It's the same deal. You put women on a whole bunch of these hormones, and they go into puberty at age 7, or they go into puberty at age 3 now. They have babies at age 5 now. Look it up. And those are extreme cases. You know, you've got puberty now coming down to the age of 10 for Western girls. It's supposed to be 14 or 15. 14 or 15, ladies and gentlemen. And I look at these little girls, and they look like women. It's incredible. And it's because of what is in the food, what is in the water. We try to feed our daughters nothing but non-GMO, really high-quality stuff, but they still end up eating meat and stuff and, you know, P. Terry's hamburgers, whatever they claim are organic. And I was looking at my 9-year-old daughter last night, and she looks like she is 14. And now she's very athletic and in really good shape, and she's not going into puberty yet, but undoubtedly some of the stuff's passing through and getting to her. And my son eats so healthy that he's more masculine than any boy at the sporting events. I mean, he is just, he's going to end up being like 6'5". I'm like 5'11". He's already got giant muscular arms. I'm telling you, something's going on, folks. The environment is just chock full of unnatural stuff. And my son, we have him on a pretty serious exercise regimen. That's part of it. But he is just a total bruiser. And my 6-year-old daughter is a bruiser. And I look at little girls at the mall. You'll see their mother and their father. You can tell they're their biological parents. And they'll be 5'10", and their daughters are 6'3". And I'm telling you, folks, it's the GMO. It's the hormones. It's out there. And it's a serious situation. So let's continue reading this. Oh, disease-free designer babies, the headline. Oh, it's so wonderful. It's as good as Obamacare. It's as good as amnesty. It's as good as gun control. They're all total nightmares, but so what? The fruits of these people are death, folks. A new technology aimed at eliminating genetic diseases in newborns would combine the DNA of 3 people instead of just 2 to create a child. No, it's not a child. It's a biological humanoid mutation. And see, they're going to have rights for these people too, folks. You know, Ted Nugent's in trouble calling Obama a mongrel, which they can claim has some racial connotation, and I guess it does, but so what? It's free speech. Obama's like a space alien, not a mongrel to me. The point is that what are these people that have had the government and big corporations go in and tinker with their genetics and combine three people? That's not a human. They go on to say, potentially redrawing ethical lines for designer babies. The process works by replacing potentially variant DNA. See, it's potentially bad. It's not that all the GMO and chemicals are triggering the cancers and things. No. It's potentially variant, you understand? DNA in the unfertilized eggs of a hopeful mother with disease-free genes. Disease-free. They're saying your genes are disease. From a donor, U.S. regulators today will begin weighing whether the procedure used only in monkeys so far is safe enough to be tested in humans. Hey, sorry, you know, the psychological written by the Democratic Party manual says if you don't like government, that's mentally ill. Oh, the genetics here show that he's going to be an aggressive leader. That's mentally ill. We're going to have to change those genetics. Who do they target with the Adderall and the Ritalin is the leadership males, to burn their brains out with the amphetamine. Because the process would change only a small specific part of the genetic code, yeah, scientists say a baby would largely retain the physical characteristics of the parents. Still, DNA from all three, mother, father, and donor, would remain with the child throughout the lifetime, opening questions about long-term effects for the generation. When they have more kids and the mutation starts, and potentially the next, that's the key. Ethicists worry that allowing pre-birth gene manipulation may one day lead to build-to-order designer babies. It's already going on. I was there when Charlie Sheen decided to spin the sperm on his kids to make sure he had boys. And you can argue, well, he only had girls before. He has a predisposition for girls. He wants boys. Yeah, but then where does it lead after that? Once you make this change, if a female arises from the process and goes on to have children, that change is passed on. So is it forever. Says Phil Yaske, Chief Science Officer, United Mitochondrial Disease Foundation. Yeah, see, it's the, by the way, I never even read this article. I knew it would be all about the mitochondrial DNA. Said by telephone, that's uncharted territory. We just don't know what it means. No, we do know what it means. Massive mutation. Permanent change of human germline has never been done before. Yeah, it has in secret laboratories. And we don't know what will happen in the future generations. Oh, we have a really good idea. It's not going to be pretty. The Food and Drug Administration is scheduled today and tomorrow to explore the issue at a meeting with doctors and researchers scheduled to talk. The FDA will then decide whether to allow scientists at Oregon Health and Science University in Portland, who engineered the approach, to move their testing program from the macaw monkeys to women. Potentially, the procedure may cut off mitochondrial diseases that are passed down through females and occur in about 1 in 4,000 people. One example is Mila's syndrome, which causes a person to have continuing small strokes that damage their brains, leading to vision loss, problems with movement, dementia, and death, according to the National Institutes of Health. And so opens the Pandora's box. And again, you have a Russian roulette. People don't even want to have kids because they're scared of Down syndrome. You got to roll the dice, folks. That's part of life. You got to roll the dice and jump on the Mayflower and go through, you know, vomiting in the hole of the ship with rats to make it over here and have half the party die. And the last two British expeditions died before that, Jamestown and other areas. You got to take a risk. We don't know the genetic code. I mean, until a few years ago, and we knew this was a fraud, they said 98%. Or 96% of the DNA was garbage. Now they know it isn't garbage. And it's the entire genetic code of everybody before you, including other material that has the scientists becoming religious. Because there's species never before seen in there, ladies and gentlemen. We are a master creation of the super being. Even if you don't believe in that, folks, I mean, at bare minimum, there's no way this all just magically happened in an ocean and that all this came together. All the top scientists are saying it's transpermia and off-world stuff. Bare minimum, folks. If you don't believe in God, believe me, we were made. There's stuff in the DNA that is flipping the system out right now. There is all sorts of stuff in there. And it's incredible. And they're going to go in there and we're going to let the establishment, with all their social engineering and all their dirty backgrounds and all the things they've done, we're going to let them come into this, which is not transparent at all, because they proprietarily protect these companies and don't let people look into how they do it. They can hide anything they want. They've been caught doing it. This is an abomination. And it will be the end of us. If people wanted to voluntarily take their families and go onto off-world colony bases and do experimentation, I would think that's reasonable. If you want to sign on to be an experiment and do this, I think that's your issue. But you cannot do this here on this planet with a dumbed-down public that doesn't even understand what's happening. And again, I go back to what I said earlier. The elite can't even run nuclear power plants right. They can't run basically anything right. Sure, the elite are pretty smart compared to the general public, but you're not that smart. And I just can see that we're really going to destroy the planet here. This is not a good move. And I don't fear for my own body or even my own children. I fear for the species itself, because I'm committed to this species. And I admire this species, and I thank God for creating us. Your phone calls, Kevin, Matt, and many others are straight ahead. Please stay with us.
Ooh, Lord, am I trouble so hard? Ooh, Lord, am I trouble so hard? Don't nobody know my trouble but God. Don't nobody know my trouble but God.
Here's some interesting headlines. We've talked about sports being fixed. FBI believes Ali fight fixed by mob 50 years ago. That's in the Washington Times. Ralph Nader calls Obama the executioner, killing U.S. citizens outside of law with the drones. Some of the news up on Infowars.com right now. Revolt against Western banker takeover of Ukraine grows. Ukrainians demand Second Amendment in new constitution. The secret of Piers Morgan termination revealed. That's a video report. Secret U.S. government watch list forces companies to place hold on orders. That's a big deal. I'm going to cover that in the next hour after calls. Man assaulted by Maryland police for filming. Arrest. And a lot more up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Another top banker has been found dead. That's happening every couple of days now. Here's my final point on the designer babies. We're all living in a giant globalist experiment. They're trying to basically get us out of reality and insert us into their controlled television, psychotronic, positronic, smart grid. And we're in the clutches of really hardcore predators that think we need to be exterminated. And they're on record saying that. And most trendies you talk to go, well, there are too many people. Well, even if you believe that, you're in the crosshairs, dummy. And, you know, they'll beg for their lives when they're dying of cancer. But right now, they're just shuffling around watching, you know, sitcoms and dramas, and everything's funny to them. And it's just really disgusting. It's really weird to see a false reality being brought down upon us and to see the general public not aware of it. But I do see some major signs of awakening, and that's a positive thing. Okay, you've been holding a while. Appreciate it. Kevin in Canada, you're on the air, then Matt in the UK and others. So go ahead.
So, Alex, I got a beef I want to settle with you. So the beef that I have is I've been listening to you for 17 years, longer than I've even known my wife. I think I got a pretty good read on you. The problem is your operation is starting to seem more and more like a church, where there's tons of preaching and money-making, but not a lot of change. And before you respond to that, Alex, I just want to say one more thing. Jesse Ventura, Larry Pratt, Max Kaiser, whenever they are questioned about you, they don't stand behind you like you stand behind them.
Well, I don't even care what people say bad about me. And I've heard Jesse say a lot of nice things about me on different shows and things. So, and I've heard Kaiser say a lot of nice things without me even looking for it. But if someone attacks someone on one of my views, I don't expect them to defend something that they disagree with. But look, I'm going to put you on hold for a minute. I'm going to come back to you, but I'm going to try to respond to what you just said. None of us are perfect, number one. Number two, I cover the issues and try to give people knowledge, believing in you that you'll be able to check out the info yourself, learn even more than I know, and then go out and affect change. I have trailblazed alternative media. We have reached hundreds of millions of people total, and we promote liberty. But for people to say you've never fixed anything, Alex, or you know, you haven't come up with some master plan to reverse everything, I'm up here saying don't authorize designer babies. I'm up here saying let's get rid of abortion. I'm up here saying it's not good to finance a war in Ukraine. We helped stop the Syria war. Even the Syria government said that. Even our own corrupt government said that. I just don't get the criticism. You say making a lot of money. It takes a lot of money to run this operation. I don't get NPR money from taxpayers or stimulus money like MSNBC. But then I'm even dirtier that I would sell high-quality products to finance our operation. It's just amazing. I'm going to come back to you. By the way, InfoWarsStore.com. I didn't plug this hour. We need your financial support. Great products. InfoWarsStore.com. Thanks for reminding me about that, Kevin.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
The headline from an agency French press is Geoengineering No Holy Grail. That's the chemtrailing operation hidden in plain view. Now 20 kids have polio-like illnesses out in California. May become thousands, folks. It's in the vaccines. We're going to cover that. That's just some of it. Black pastors want Holder impeached. Okay, let's go back because he asked this question. We were up against the break. I responded to it. He said he has a beef with me that this show is more like a church. And I did just spend 45 minutes speaking out against cloning and genetic engineering. A, because we don't know where it's going. B, because the elite admit it can cause mutations down the line. And C, they've been caught Trojan horsing things. I mean, I'm here criticizing George Soros funding overthrows overseas. I'm just here trying to cover real news. I mean, that to cover false flag terror attacks, to cover the Boston bombing being staged and have our reporter take over press conferences, that's stuff you get killed for. I got death threats over that, and so did Dan Bidondi. Serious ones. And I'm not calling for people's support or thanks, but, man, I work 18 hours a day many days, and I've been doing this 19 years, and you know, I don't make any apologies about the fact that I drive a nice Ford F-150 pickup truck, and I don't, and I live in a you know decent house, and I wear okay clothes, but I don't worship materialism. It's not my God. It's way down the line on my pyramid of hierarchy of needs. For those that know what a hierarchy of needs is, you know, up at the top is helping others and building a better civilization and spirituality. At the bottom of it is housing and clothing and heating and cooling and things like that. But, I mean, I'm more than happy to be criticized by anything legitimate by the caller that's been listening 17 years. I mean, Kevin, I think we've had some real success stories with this broadcast, and I think we've gotten better over time here on air at really articulating a lot of serious social issues that need to be discussed and debated. I'm just trying to get people to realize reality is a lot deeper and wider than what mainstream media is trying to project. But set me right. I mean, explain to me how I'm a church. Explain it all to me.
Well, first off, thanks for letting me respond, because you literally could have let me go. So thanks for letting me respond.
I love being criticized. It's actually boring to be thanked. I mean, tell me, though.
Yeah. And secondly, remember, I'm a 17-year listener. Everything that you've ever talked about, I listen every single day. Everything you ever talked about, that goes into my brain. So I'm not.
Well, I mean, I think after 17 years, people get irritated with something. I get irritated with myself. Maybe you need a break from the show. Maybe you should do your own show.
That's actually funny that you mentioned that, because I was thinking the same thing for you. And the reason why I say that is because If I'm a 17-year listener and I'm starting to lose a bit of faith, there must be a reason why. It's not just because I'm listening.
No, it's because you start associating me covering the problems with the problems at a subconscious level.
Well, I think it's actually a little bit more than that. And you're probably right, but I think what it has more to do with is I know you're right, and a lot of people do as well. But for the last 17 years, if you had to measure your accomplishments or your trophies by either what you've done to change, whether it be drone killings, whether it be poisoning the water. If you had
We're actually getting fluoride pulled out all over the place, but I don't deserve but a small part of that credit. See, I totally disagree with you. Most people know the Federal Reserve's private now. Most people know there's a world government now. I mean, people didn't know any of this 15 years ago. And if you ask the average person who got them thinking, they will tell you Alex Jones. I don't know how you can say we're a failure when we've been a raving, wild, exploding success, or to quote Robert Duvall in Network, a big bleeping hit.
You were a failure. In fact, I think you're missing what I'm telling you. What I'm telling you is the people that you should actually be reaching out to the most, the ones that have been listening to you for 17 years, not 3 years and don't have a job. I work every single day and even on the weekends, but yet I still listen to you. My friend, you just have to have a little bit of patience and just hear what I'm saying. You're listening to a guy who takes heat from his wife because of the amount of time I listen to you.
Yeah, but you're mad because you're awake and not living in the Matrix. I didn't do that.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
All right, I want to hurry through your phone calls. Toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. I've been giving the last caller about 10 minutes, but I want him to finish up his point. He's being critical. I want to find out exactly what he's getting at. Then coming up, geoengineering, no holy grail in, quote, climate change. There's massive geoengineering going on, changing our climate, basically terraforming it. Also, Berkeley girl among California children who contracted polio-like illness. It's up to 20. By the way, these have been vaccinated children, I should add. Whenever I hear about polio-like outbreaks, where it's not polio, it's always vaccine-related overseas. And I think that's the main culprit here, the main suspect that should be looked at. That is coming up right now. Let's go back to Kevin. Kevin, I'm going to give you about a minute to quantify your criticism as a 17-year listener, exactly what you're getting at. Go ahead.
Great. I'll make it quick. You keep pushing the mute button there, so I can't actually get out what I'm trying to say. But I'll make
hey,
it
hold
really
on just a minute.
You.
Hold on just a minute. Now, see? You had about a minute or so before we went to break last hour. You had a couple minutes of that short segment, and you're on air right now. Are you? Hold on. Put him on hold. Now, that's not a fair intellectual discussion. I'm not hitting a mute button on you. I don't have control of this phone call. They're airing it in there. Now, I just told them to turn you down so I could talk. That's a fake intellectual argument to call in and say that I'm muting you when I'm giving you about three times longer than the other callers have had today. Now, I'm going to give you 2 minutes, and I'm watching the clock. It's going to be 10 after in 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You got 2 minutes. Go ahead.
Okay. I would appreciate if you could, since you say that Jesse Ventura, Larry Pratt, Max Kaiser, all have something good to say about you in public, on TV, or some kind of video recording. If you could just give me 3 for each, that I could go look, 3 for each, and I'll go out and have a look, because you're the one that say that we're supposed to stick together and have each other's backs. And when I look at Jesse Ventura, who I look up to just as much as I look up to you, and I look at Larry Pratt, the exact same thing, and they're not backing you. That's all I have to say, Alex. You can use the rest for another caller.
Okay, so that's your criticism of me? That's why I'm bad? I mean, that sounded like high school or something. I don't follow a lot of what Jesse Ventura and Larry Pratt do because I'm busy, but I've actually heard Jesse Ventura say nice things about me on other shows, and I've actually heard Max Kaiser say nice things about me without even trying to find it. Now, I'm sure they disagree with me on some issues, and that probably gets brought up, but what is that even about? Listen, it's not my job, and I want to be clear about something here. People always tell me, hey, Alex, you're paranoid. No, I'm not paranoid when I know about thousands of declassified studies using lethal chemicals, biologicals, radiologicals on veterans, on foster kids, you name it. That shows me we've had a long-term scientific elite that Eisenhower warned us of that's doing a lot of secret evil testing on the public to set that precedent. And I know about the U.S. code that claims as long as it's for law enforcement or research purposes, even lethal testing, they claim is legal. Well, I say that's a fraudulent law in the U.S. code. It's in Title 50, Chapter 32. It bars secret testing but then authorizes it for law enforcement or research purposes. And so I'm just up here trying to get people to think about big issues like that and all the secret testing and things that are going on. I'm not trying to sound popular. I'm not trying to say what's palatable for the establishment. I'm not trying to go along with the system's talking points so that the system will put me on air. I am trying to build my own media system, and I'm trying to be as true as I can to the truth and to try to be as accurate as I can with all this research and information to really tell people what's going on in the world. And I think if you go back to what I was saying 17, 18, 19 years ago now on air, you will hear those old shows. We ought to re-air some of those from like 15 years ago. And it is like I was in a time machine breaking down what was going to happen. But I'm not in a time machine. The globalists are very public about their programs. It's all a giant scientific test with them tweaking and changing, but it all basically goes in the same direction. And so I don't care what other people say about me on air. I don't care. I mean, you could take somebody like Mark Dice, who I put on the map. He's a talented guy. 8-9 years ago, he'd do these videos and write books and stuff, and I helped him more than anybody get a niche in media as a media analyst. He's got, I guess, an RTF degree. And then he got mad at me a few years ago and, you know, basically made up a bunch of stuff and attacked me. And then after his attacks failed, after about a year, I said to him, the prodigal son, I said, you're doing a lot of really good work. And I said, I forgive you. And I just did all this to show you a life lesson. And as I mature more, I realize it doesn't matter if people deny me to other folks when they're under pressure or they buy into the Cass Sunstein, you know, attack system of, you know, Alex Jones is being attacked. I'll be popular if I attack him. I'm being attacked because I'm on point. I'm being attacked because I'm on target. And if you're over the target with a bomber, you're going to have flak. You're going to have the big guns firing at you and then exploding rounds that send shrapnel out. So I fly into the flak. If I'm not being attacked, if I'm not getting controversy, if I'm not being demonized, I'm not doing my job. And it's that simple. And I'm here to get people out of their comfort zone. I'm here to shake people out of their trance. And if it was shocking to a nation of zombies, even mainline conservatives, to have me yell and scream at the BBC or yell and say this isn't a game to Piers Morgan, you notice in hindsight, everyone says it's one of the best moments in TV ever. That's all over the news the last 2 days. People say it's a defining moment. I had a major publisher call me yesterday and some media analysts, and they were saying, we believe that's when the tide turned in the debate on the Second Amendment was when we just called it all out. And I'm not giving myself credit, but folks, when you're under attack and the enemy is flagrantly violating your rights and nakedly stomping around, playing patty cake and being soft-voiced about it is a recipe of slaves. But I'll be the first to tell you I could do a better job. In hindsight, a lot of times when I hear my show or when I make a mistake. But it doesn't matter. I'm in the arena doing the best I can. So I've learned to just move forward. And I think it's good to get some criticism sometimes. You know, it's good. But at the same time, it becomes a distraction and there's never really any meat to it. Or there's made up rumors or there's, you know, all this other garbage. You know, if you hear somebody not back me up or say something, You talk to them. Don't talk to me. I'm not my brother's keeper. Okay? And that's what it comes down to, is that I'm here to try to promote other people that have interesting ideas to get people thinking. I'm not here to promote myself. I'm here to die if need be, because I want to live forever through my progeny. I want humanity to succeed. I care about the big game. I care about the long-term goals. I'm alive. It's that simple. All right, we've been making people hold way too long. Matt is in the United Kingdom, and I apologize for making you hold so long, but I had to respond to that caller. Matt, go ahead. You're on the air.
That's fine. Hello, Alex. How you doing, buddy? Basically, I agree with everything you're saying there. It was quite a moving little speech there. Piers Morgan, last night, all over the BBC, they're ripping him to bits, bud. You know, they showed the best bit of you roasting him. You know, it was all you. What a milestone, what a success to get rid of him. Here's the vampire, blood-sucking vampire, reptile. Call him what you want, but you've done it, buddy, and that was down to you, so well done.
It was Matt Drudge. It becomes really almost ridiculous how much I thank Matt Drudge, but he deserves it. It was Matt Drudge put a tweet out to them, and that's why they called me. And weeks after he did it, they go, no, Matt Drudge's tweet, you know, we think it's a great idea. And then I went, that's Matt Drudge, never talking, just keeps walking, doing his magic, helping fight the tyranny. Go ahead.
Well, I think you should celebrate with a 1776 album, you know, with all your own music, because it's good. And I wish there was more of it, to be honest with you. You know what I mean?
I hear you, brother. There's so much we can do. What do you think overall of the cloning news and the genetics of three parents into one baby?
Oh, well, you're talking major ethical issues there, really. Let's be honest. I mean, the human soul is a very precious thing. And is it ethical to, you know, factory produce human souls? No, it's not. And that's essentially what we're going to be doing. So it opens up massive ethical debates. No, it's definitely wrong. And then, of course, you've got the GMO and all the diseases and everything else. No, definitely not. Definitely not.
Well, that's the key. They give us all this garbage to destroy our genetics, and then we have to go to them to have kids, and then they backdoor all their changes into us to make us literally servile biological androids, in Aldous Huxley's own words.
Yeah, well, that's the plan, you see. I mean, I was doing a psychotherapy course at the local university, and they were teaching behaviorism. You know, we're all animals, and it was that's the mainstream
thing. We have no free will, and it's all stimuli. The truth is, they want our free will. They want our soul.
They want to enslave us. They want your soul, and they will deny the human spirit. They deny determinism. The only way that they can control you is with psychotropic medication. You know, if they treat you like an animal, we're not animals. We have that animal nature, but we have part of the animal brain, but we have the conscious mind. The animals don't have that.
And we have the ability to change our environment and envision things. Exactly. Beethoven's not an animal. Vincent van Gogh's not an animal. We are an incredible divine species made in the image of the Creator. We are made by the Creator of the universe. All the evidence shows that we're an advanced technology created by the Creator of the universe. We are a conscious technology that God experiences the universe through us as just another manifestation of our Creator made in God's image. And these blasphemous control freaks know that full well. And that's why they want to attack the creation, my friend.
That's right. I agree. Watford. I was at Watford. You were the boss. Oxford. How'd I get tickets?
You know, I've asked the guys for that, and they sent me. I think it's for Oxford University and faculty members only, but we need to find out. I think there's a way you can call them and see if you can get in. I'm speaking in Oxford coming up, what is it, the 12th of March. I'll be back in Albion, the beautiful isle. We'll be right back.
We want your soul.
Defending the Republic from enemies, foreign and domestic. It's Alex Jones.
Tell us your habits, your facts, your fears. Give us your address, your shoe size, your ears, your digits, your plans, your number, your eyes, your schedule, your desktop, your details, your life. Show us your children, your photos, your home. Here. Take credit, take insurance, take a loan, get a job, get a pension, get a haircut, get a suit, play the lottery, play football, play the field,
so it's not time.
Think about it. Deep space, Milky Way galaxy, two-thirds of the way out, orbiting standard sun. We've got all these weirdos in suits telling us what to do and telling us they're the universe and they're the world. And take these pills with chips in them. We're going to track everything you do. Blasting the airwaves, electromagnetic radiation. We are living in a total Twilight Zone episode. You're on a planet, ladies and gentlemen, with an atmosphere that has less of a thickness than the skin of an apple compared to the crust and mantle and core. And we are literally just hurtling through deep space at hundreds of thousands of miles an hour, staring out into the void, comets, shooting stars, all the life forms, all of it. I mean, it is just incredible. Consciousness is just totally over the chart, amazing. And I'm telling you, these mummies like Hillary Clinton and these mummies like the people on The View and just all of these nobodies and Eric Holder and Hillary all kissing all over the new MSNBC host and the pretty boy and all of it means nothing. Nothing. And these people are not gods and they will not attain the life extension. They're going to get none of it. They will be destroyed in their attempt to destroy humanity in their incredible selfishness. And I know that in my gut as much as I know that my brain has literal sensors in it to pick up the magnetic lines of this planet now proven in humans. It's in geese. It's in everything. The sixth sense has been proven as magnetic. All of it. And there's so many other senses we have. We're so much more incredible than these scum tell us we all are. I'm sick of them telling us we're scum. I'm sick of them telling us we're weak when they're the scum. I'm sick of them telling us we need them. No. They need us. They're parasites. Let's go to Simon in Florida. Thanks for holding, Simon. You're on the air. Then Duke.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, bro.
Hey, man. You're absolutely correct. When you're on target, that's when the enemy attacks the most. I'm Simon in Florida. I broke the story about the Florida unemployment website glitches. And I just want to talk about Deloitte, the company who actually designed that website. Deloitte, I'm just going to read a quick paragraph for you, okay? Deloitte has been involved in the auditing of some of the biggest banking institutions over the past several years.
Yeah, they're the new Arthur Anderson.
Yeah, leading up to the financial crisis. They were found to have been deeply involved in obvious securities frauds. Fraud that involved fake mortgage assets. Taylor Bean and Whitaker Mortgage Corporation, look that up. The sharing of confidential information on several occasions. They were busted for being involved with clients that were caught money laundering, HSBC, for example. And they paid settlements of undisclosed amounts for their fraud involvement. Deloitte has been involved in so many scandals that make your head spin. In February of 2007, the Federal Reserve of New York's board extended the contract of international auditing company Deloitte Touche Tohmatsu Limited. The future Treasury Secretary at the time, Tim Geithner, was president of the New York Fed at the time.
And by the way, they're tied into the NSA, too.
Even though Deloitte violated the New York banking law, Statute 3610, by disclosing confidential information of other Deloitte clients to Standard Chartered, and that was just the tip of the iceberg, Deloitte's interests here in Florida are protected by one of the most powerful lobbyists in Tallahassee, Brian Ballard, who is a major campaign fundraiser for Governor Rick Scott and the other GOP officials. So you got to imagine... He's up for re-election, and that whole thing, all those people that dropped out, you know, not getting paid for 6 weeks, can't file, the numbers came down. When they came down under 7%, they were able to drop the federal extensions. So all these people drop off, the unemployment numbers come down, and Rick Scott looks great.
Sure, they're gaming all the unemployment numbers and the inflation numbers, everything. It's as phony as a $3 bill.
Well, they 283.4 million in contracts in Florida alone. And they did this in three other states?
Well, that's the thing about a technocracy, is it allows them, with the high-frequency trading, all of it, to game things to a whole new level.
Wow, it's just unbelievable. And I have one other thing to talk about. Abby Martin, you know, she asked Rand Paul a question about his support of Mitt Romney. This is over a year ago. And he tried to get her fired from RT and had the Capitol Police contact her. It's an unbelievable story.
Yeah, I think that's what some of their staffers did, but I didn't like Rand Paul doing that. But she doesn't like me either. I've done nothing to her. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
You are obsolete, Mr. Wordsworth.
A lie. No man is obsolete.
You have no function, Mr. Wordsworth. You're an anachronism, like a ghost from another time.
I am nothing more than a reminder to you that you cannot destroy truth by burning pages.
You're a bug, Mr. Wordsworth, a crawling insect, an ugly, misformed little creature who has no purpose here, no meaning.
I am a human being. Words, Mr. Wordsworth, that have no substance and no dimension, like air, like the wind. I don't care. I tell you, I don't care. I'm a human being. I exist. And if I speak one thought aloud, that thought lives, even after I'm shoveled into my grave.
Delusions, Mr. Wordsworth. Delusions that you inject into your veins to make you think you have a strength when you have no strength at all. You have nothing but spindly limbs and a dream, and the state has no use for your kind.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
Broadcasting worldwide. Thank you so much for joining us. I got a bunch of news I want to get to on geoengineering. On a new poll out, majority are angry and upset about the idea of government policing the news, but still a sizable portion are not fazed at threat to freedom of the press. That just went up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. But right now, Duke and John and many others you've been holding patiently. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. Really superb callers today. Duke, thanks for calling from Oklahoma. Go ahead.
Thanks. I'd like to talk about a couple of things that I found out on GMOs and the police state. On the genetically modified foods, I've taken it upon myself to go to these grocery stores and talk to the managers to find out if they even know where their food comes from. Well, 8 out of 10 don't even know where their vegetables come from. So if that's not a red flag, I don't know what is. The other thing I'd like to talk about is the police state that we're finding ourselves in. Oklahoma has found themselves $13 million in unpaid parking tickets, and they've got a new program with the marshal's office going on where they literally kick down your door, knock down your door, and come in your house and take you to jail over a parking ticket.
Continue.
What are your thoughts?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Well, I just had a glitch for a minute. Back up 10 seconds.
Well, on the police state,
yeah.
Oklahoma City's found that they have $13 million worth of unpaid parking fines.
Oh, yeah.
So they have made a connection with the marshal's office to beat down people's doors on these parking tickets.
Oh, I know. They now send police, even SWAT teams, for parking tickets and things. They arrest folks for no seatbelt. It's all about getting us in the system.
On the news, they're not showing that. On the news, they're showing one marshal knocking on your door real politely. But I have a friend that just got thrown in jail, and when he answered the door, they threw him down, took him to jail, and went in his house unlawfully while his wife was in bed naked.
Of course.
I'm just a good old country boy at heart. You know, I'm just like, I think
that's not what goes on in a free country. Our police are internationally trained and controlled. They're out of control. They're training like an occupied army, and they've got this attitude that they're keeping us safe. No. At the top, Homeland Security staged major terror attacks. It is a criminal group. Go ahead.
Do they not know that we're preparing to? I mean, I don't have children. I'm not married. I am not going to let someone molest my home or my property without fighting for it. I mean, I'm just not that type of guy.
Brother, they're bringing back debtor prisons now that are even illegal. They don't care. They still throw you in jail in Illinois. This is a lawless takeover.
They won't take me alive. I'm not that type of person. I'm a good old boy, and I believe in good morals and values. I believe that I'm a good person. I do not like to see people suffer, but I am not going to take this kind of crap on my property, especially.
No, I hear you. I hear you. And that's why they're getting armored vehicles and gearing up. They want a war with us so bad they can taste it. And not even the average cop, but their bosses are people that want to teach American school children 2 + 2 = 5. Literally. I mean, that says everything you need to know about these people. They are the scum of the earth. Anything else, Duke? What was your other take on the GMO? You had something else to say?
Well, on the GMOs, we've got a couple natural places around in Oklahoma City, Sprouts and Whole Foods and everything, and I've gone to even them, and they don't even the managers have no idea where this food comes from. They cannot tell you where it comes from.
Well, a lot of it's certified, a lot of it isn't, but a lot of stuff at Whole Paycheck, Whole Foods is not non-GMO organic, but a lot of it is. It'll actually have numbers on it, and it'll be listed. But I hear you, and I appreciate your call. And again, folks, it isn't like they cross two squash to make a better squash with open pollination with a hybrid. This is where they go in and fundamentally change the plant. And a lot of these things are plants that grow their own pesticide off of bacteria toxins or fungus toxins. And they argue, well, this fungus normally occurs in corn. Yeah, they boost it 1,000 times with the BT Monsanto corn. There's other varieties. They take it and boost the toxin 1,000 times what sometimes naturally occurs and is a natural pesticide. It's a symbiotic relationship with the corn and other plants and the fungus or the bacteria, depending on which one it is. And then if bugs eat it, they die, folks. And then we're eating it. It's a pharmacological crop. Look it up. 15 years ago, they were growing live HIV in corn, open air in Texas. That's what's going on. They can grow chemicals in corn. They can engineer corn to grow Coca-Cola in it if they want. That's how neat plants are. Look up pharmacological crops. They can do anything. We're not in Kansas anymore, folks. We are in the advanced 21st century. The year is probably about 2045 right now, to technologically speaking. John in Michigan, you're on the air.
Hey, Alex. I'm calling mainly because, we were bought at a price, and so we cannot become slaves of men, you know? And, like, government, as I see it, is just man, you know? So
it's systems of extraction, systems of enslavement, systems of authoritarianism.
Right. And mainly, I've had this idea for a while. Like, I don't know why everyone doesn't, you know, file suit towards the IRS, mainly because for stealing our identities. Everyone, you know, throws a lot of words around, citizens, person, all this, but like the legal, you know, definitions, there's three different definitions for the term United States. You know, there's the country, the United States, and there's the federal zone, the United States, and then there's the collective states of the union, you know, and like, the same thing turns to what a citizen, you know, we're not citizens. If you're born in this country or your parents were, you know, you're a national, you're a state national, you're a member of your state. And like,
That's right. Originally you were a citizen of your state, and then they had for a mutual defense combine the federal government.
Yeah. And it's sad because a lot of people don't grow up learning any of that. And like, also,
sir, the average American doesn't know that the earth orbits the sun.
It's pretty insane. Main person I think you should have on the show too, Deborah Tavares, because she's the smart meter lady, you know, silent weapons for quiet wars.
I think we've had her on a couple times. Very, very interesting lady, John.
She's very even into this like taxation stuff. But I think we should file suit against the IRS for stealing our identities. I mean, because most people send in the 1040 and being residents.
Plus, you violate your Fourth Amendment, your Fifth Amendment. You waive your right to incrimination. I appreciate your call. Money Magazine's done, and others have done 30, 40, 50 different tax returns. The same tax return to different CPAs. They all give you a different answer. And, again, it was set up in 1913, the Federal Reserve. That same week, they passed the IRS Act. It wasn't even widespread implemented until the 50s. It is a tax to offshore banks. And that's just an absolute fact. Ronald Reagan's own commission found in 81, not 1 cent of the IRS money goes to run the country. It goes to interest on the debt to offshore banks, which the debt only gets bigger because that's how they control us. Just like banks don't want a farmer to ever get out of debt. I mean, this is really 101, folks. And old timers knew this, so we couldn't be enslaved. I mean, we are so enslaved, it is just unbelievable. Clinton, Ohio. Clinton, you're on the air.
Hello. Yes, I'm calling because of the Teddy's Law that I emailed you about. I emailed The Blaze. I emailed Coast to Coast. And
all right, well, tell me about the law. What is it?
That was the Teddy's Law, where they're going to have CSB come into your house if you wanted to homeschool and inspect.
Oh, yeah,
home.
That was in that's in Ohio.
Right. I emailed you, and the next day you covered it, man. So as far as anybody saying you don't change anything, that law was gone in 2 days. We had people from the Philippines, from Canada, from Romania, from Israel, Germany, and the UK all call that senator and say that that's ridiculous. So I know you always have adults calling up. and saying your stuff. So here, this is for the future generation, man.
Thank you, Mr. Jones.
Thank you, Mr. Jones. Thank you, Mr. Jones.
So you did do something, man. Don't let anybody tell you. And there's the kids. That's what it's all about.
Beautiful. Anything else, Clint?
Nope, that's it. Keep up the good work, man.
I will, brother. Imagine the horror of being Clint, where they're going to send CPS to every homeschooler's home to open a criminal investigation that you're an abuser, or make you get a teaching certificate to be able to homeschool your children. That's the final domino, folks, coming for our kids. Doesn't matter the homeschoolers win all the spelling bees, all the geography bees, that they're sought after by colleges and get full tuitions and scholarships. It doesn't matter that statistically they're not all screwed up. And again, homeschooling really isn't even homeschooling. There's these giant communities of homeschoolers. It's people that want out of the system, and that's what's so good about it. I mean, my parents were naive. They were really good people, but they grew up in the 50s. They put me in high school in Dallas, and it was unbelievable. The sex. People are like, oh, that sounds fun. No, it wasn't fun. The fighting. The drugs, which I never got into. The corrupt police. The meanness of the people. The persecution of nerds. The cliques. And I was like an animal in high school. And so I was oblivious to it all and didn't even know that, you know, I'd been basically the most popular person in school, because I was just completely like a mad dog, you know, just not in a bad way, but like an animal. I was just, didn't even click into any of it and didn't follow anybody's style, didn't you know, go with any of that, and saw the disdain by the cliques and things and all told them they were scum to their face. But even though I was super popular, I was in high school 3 years in Dallas, because I was in so much trouble 1 year where I had to take off half the year and go work on the ranch. And then 2 years in Austin, I came to Austin and just kept my head down and, you know, ended up making straight hundreds and just got out of school. But I didn't mean to get off into myself and say I was popular in high school. My point was, is that it was a bad experience. It was a really bad experience. It was empty. And I just cannot imagine throwing my children in sixth grade, where kids that have flunked four grades, who are really 14, and you're 11, and they're beating you up. I mean, gangs beating you up. It's got to be 100 times I was beat up before I started literally just stomping the hell out of people. But my whole point is that, and I guess it made me who I am today, but I would not want that on my children. And I'm not knocking my parents. I know they listen. They were old school, you know, coming with black eyes. Well, you just better be tougher next time. And that wasn't some macho bravado thing. That's just what old-time Texans are like. That's how my dad's dad was to him. But it's just a different world, absolutely different world. These public schools are hellish, ladies and gentlemen. Some of them aren't that bad in rural areas, but my God, big cities, whew, man, might as well just put your kid in a juvenile hall. It's bad. And the problem is, you beat up one gang member, you got to fight the rest of them later. Then you beat them up, and you got to beat up their big brothers. Then you got to beat up their ex-con, you know, older cousin who's 25 years old when you're 16. I mean, that's Dallas for you. You know, somebody, you're at a Sonic, and somebody comes out of the back of a truck with a knife trying to kill you. I mean, it's just animal land. I tell you, one thing I like about liberals in Austin, Texas, at least it's changing now because all the Dallas folks are moving in and stuff, is that people don't kill each other all over the place. And I really don't like getting in fights with people. I really don't like everybody got something to prove and starting trouble, because, I mean, I've had enough of it, a lot of it. Let's go ahead and talk to Ray in Texas. Ray, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. How are you doing, man? Long time no talk.
Yeah, brother. What's on your mind today?
If you look up KVUE, man claims DPS falsely arrested him. I'm surprised that you haven't put my video on there, man. You actually have somebody fighting back that knew his rights, that knew the laws.
Well, I must have missed it. Tell me. It's KVUE. That's local TV. And again,
right.
Austin.
Man claims DPS falsely arrested him.
Okay, I haven't seen that video. What happened?
There's two videos on there. And the police violated, I believe it was 8 of my constitutional rights, and I believe they committed 120 felonies amongst the 6 officers.
Okay, well, I haven't seen the video. What happened to you?
Well, it's a long story. I need to sit down and talk with you about it. I mean, it's a long story, but they committed so many felonies in the jail and otherwise. I mean, just like the bond, they violated my constitutional right by, it should have been like a $200 bond, which actually it shouldn't have been anything at all, but they gave me an $8,000 bond.
Well, let me tell you, the state of Texas, I was talking to a friend and he showed it to me. I want to do a piece on it. He has a 1993 Chevy Silverado. It's worth about $3,000 on a good day in the Blue Book. And he went in to get license and registration because he bought it from his buddy for $3,000. And they told him this thing is worth $57,000, even though all the books show different. And we want something like $12,000. And they laughed at him and said, go get a state appraiser. Well, he can't find a state appraiser. And when he goes in, they all laugh at him. And that's happened to everybody I know. The states are just robbing everyone. And if you get arrested for, you know, not having your driver's license on you or whatever, when you get there, they'll do all these fines and fees. Yeah, I know. The government's just gone to seed. And the government's been told, raise taxes over and over again raise taxes or you're going to go bankrupt. Well, no amount could ever keep us from going bankrupt because they want us to go bankrupt. But listen, a caller called earlier and said, thanks for calling. Thanks for covering how they tried to ban homeschooling in Ohio. Okay, I'm glad I saw that and covered it. I remember covering it. But, I mean, I'm not omnipresent, bro. I don't know about your case with the DPS. You say you're surprised I didn't cover it.
It's just somebody that stood up to them and fought back and is winning.
No, I know. But, I mean, do you understand that I didn't know about it?
No, I understand. You have a lot on your plate.
No, but you're saying you're surprised. I mean, so you're winning. How are you winning?
We won our 12-6 against the APD.
Well, that's good. I'll look up your video. I appreciate your call. We got Chris in New Hampshire, Fred in Canada, Dave in Michigan, Jay in Wyoming. I don't know if I can get to all of you, but I'll try. Did a good job today. Took a lot of phone calls. You know, there's a study out that being in a dark room makes you think better. And when I'm in there with just a couple lights on, no cameras on, I'm very relaxed today. Also did a grueling workout this morning. Super grueling, folks. And I am just absolutely in a very relaxed mode. I hope everybody's okay with that today. Not the normal Tasmanian devil.
I'm ready for it.
How, how. Well, here it's fine. Ah, LaGrange. Down on the ranch. They got some really nice girls, yeah. How, how, how. Wonder what this song's about.
But now I might be mistaken.
By the way, folks, this hour was brought to you by MyPatriotSupply.com. /Alex to find their specials. MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex. Non-GMO, great customer service ratings. It's who I've chosen to use. You need to be prepared and not be dependent on the system. I think that's obvious. MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex. And please don't forget, we have the Super Male Vitality with the 8 super herbs concentrated to naturally try to block the estrogen mimickers in your body. And just really supercharge your overall energy, libido, so many other things. Weight loss, for me personally. We only bring you the very best at InfoWarsLife.com. And your purchase of the Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine, the Fluoride Shield Detoxer, the Super Male Vitality, all of it, I believe, will contribute to a better lifestyle for you and health. Just like the great Southern Mexico, High Mountain, Chiapas, organic, volcanic soil grown. Arabica is my favorite. We have 2 different blends. I hope you'll check that out and try that out at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. You know, I took a lot of calls today, and like I said, I had pneumonia last week, and I've still got a little bit of a hoarse voice, so I'm not trying to talk like Batman. I'll assure you this is what my voice sounds like, but I probably need to take some time off. I'm probably going to go visit a voice doctor. I've never really gone and had my, a throat, eye, or whatever they call it, doctor. I've got a good name of one just to get checked out what's going on down there. So I was seeing another doctor last week, and they recommended I do that when they were looking down my throat. after all my yelling and screaming. Didn't mean to get the signature voice on purpose. There's a lot of news I haven't gotten to that's up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. One of them's really creepy. Secret U.S. government watch list forces companies to place hold on orders. Australian David Jones told his order had been delayed due to the name being flagged by a database. A secret U.S. government watch list is forcing companies to place orders on hold in case they want to grab them and put spy tech in them without warrants. According to an Australian named David Jones, whose name was flagged up as suspicious when he tried to purchase computer parts. After Jones processed an innocuous order with Element 14, a large distributor of electronic and computer parts in Australia, he arrived at the company's trade counter to pick up the goods, only to be told that his order had been placed on hold. Well, the NSA admits, it came out with Snowden, that they reroute stuff worldwide to put spy tech in it. After confirming that the hold was not due to his parts being restricted or suspicious anyway, Jones was told that it wasn't the parts that had been flagged, it was his name that had been flagged. See, all commerce is tracked. And it came out in the news yesterday that the TSA pre-screening thing is, quote, under fire because it's like the NSA. I think that was AP yesterday. That's what I've been saying day one. It's an NSA scandal, folks. It's they're tracking everything you do before you ever even leave your house. And that was the winning video. Make me air the winning video tomorrow. I never announce the winner. I was supposed to announce that last week. That's how punch drunk I am and how busy. We'll announce the winner. In fact, we'll announce the winner today. And then I'll play it tomorrow. But it deals with that. And then continuing here. Nets refuses to report latest Obamacare fail. Two-thirds of small business employees see premium spike. Also, we've got other reports here dealing with geoengineering. But I am just flat out of time. You know what? I'm going to go to Overdrive. Infowars.com. As the audio streams, I'm going to Fred. Nightly news tonight, 7 o'clock.
You are listening to GCN.
Great job, crew.
Visit GCNlive.com today.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We're going back to your phone calls right now. Fred in Canada, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hello, Mr. Jones.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, how's it going?
It's going all right.
I see you're very relaxed today. That's good to see you're relaxed for a change.
I am a little bit relaxed. My life's so insane. Why not?
Hey, why not? It's always good to take one day of, this one day to relax for a minute. The reason why I'm calling is because I discovered you about 9 months ago, and then I took a trip to Beirut, Lebanon for about 8 days. I had to go for a wedding. And I suggest that anybody who doesn't know what's going on in the world to get out of it for a minute and then come back to it and realize what you have. Because we truly don't understand the freedoms that we do have, even though we are slaves. We don't realize how much freedoms we have until we go somewhere and they're completely taken away from you. Because when I was there, all I felt was fear. All I felt was, I felt like a literal slave. Like, the movie 12 Years a Slave, that doesn't compare to what I went through in those 8 days. Like, honestly, I would have much rather someone whip me. At least I know who my who my master would be. I'd rather that than go somewhere and be
describe what it was like to visit the Middle East.
Oh my goodness, where do I start? The first day I got there, the next day there was a car bombing in a supermarket, or it was a clothing area to buy clothes. Two girls that were best friends were buying dresses to their prom or a school dance, and they both got killed. For what? Like, there was no prime minister, there was no political influence. They just wanted to kill people. And in all honesty, it was the Saudi Arabians that are trying to do this. You know, as a child,
our loving allies, as usual, we support whoever's most horrible.
Oh yeah, obviously. But you know, as a kid, I was always told that, as you know, as a Lebanese person, you're going to be persecuted your whole life. They want you for your land. They want you for your water. They want you for your natural resources. That's not true. They want us for our oil. Apparently, there's this huge oil basin underneath the Lebanese grounds, and Israeli government right now, as we speak, are in the oceans of where you can barely see, close to Cyprus, drilling the oil out of Lebanese oil. So what they're doing now, as we speak, through the media, through television, through everything, my wife is full Lebanese, and she watches all the shows. Every show she ever watches, all they talk about is, what are you still doing here? You know, they're trying to push all the, mostly the Christians, because they know if they keep the Muslims there, you know, they'll just eventually kill themselves out. But they want to take all the Christians out, because they know we're the ones that fuck. I'm not saying that, you know, this as a Christian. I'm a very open-minded Christian person. I have a lot of best friends that are Muslim. And I think that...
No, I understand, but Christians are being persecuted. Interesting, Fred. I'm going to take one more. Sorry to Jay, Jeremy, and Chris. I got time for Dave in Michigan. Dave, go ahead.
Alex, brother. Kevin, you're an idiot. It comes from upbringing. Your parents are probably idiots, too. Alex, if you ever have a kid that acts that way, I'll disown you. Brother, sometimes I want to beat you up, but most of the time I want to give you a big, fat hug. You asked the other day, what are people doing to stay out of the system, to resist? We moved. I'm legally blind. you, thank you, brother. You and my brother Gordy helped wake me up. I moved. I got my wife to move out of the city. We moved into the country on 10 acres. We got solar. I'm fighting them, trying to keep their lying butts. They told me my net meter would be analog. They lied. It isn't. I wouldn't let them put it on. It's still not on. My meter's spinning backwards. It's awesome. I support your sponsors. Longevity saved my life because you reintroduced me to Doc Wallach, and I am telling you, you are winning. Your info war is your legacy.
Oh, brother, it's all of you, the listeners, that make it all possible. You're the people that spread the word and support us. We couldn't do it without you. God bless you, and keep fighting, Dave. Sorry to everybody else. Back tonight, 7 o'clock, InfoWars Nightly News, and back tomorrow, Lord willing, 11 a.m. Central with a weekday transmission. Now get out there, stand up against tyranny, spread the word, and let's ban these designer babies.